Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to 2014.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the CCAA Women's Basketball Championship game. I'm Eric Stenholm once again, joined by Coach Joaquin Wallace, formerly of San Francisco State. Coach, big game today. Contrasting styles maybe, but I think there's a lot of storylines to cover in this one. You got a 6 seed playing their third game. You got the 1 seed looking to win both the regular season and postseason crowns in the CCAA, and the 6 seed looking to play spoiler and snatch a bid in that NCAA tournament. What are you looking for in this game as we get ready to tip off here in Stockton?
I look for East Bay to come out with a lot of energy. This is the opportunity for them to get to the NCAA championship series. Cal State Dominguez Hills took the same road last year. They came in, they've won 3 consecutive games. Now East Bay has the opportunity to do that as well. So I look for East Bay to play hard basketball throughout. They have nothing to lose, everything to gain. And if they do get in, it'd be a great storyline for them because they're not even in the top 15 in terms of the Western region. It will have a major shakeup. Someone would have to come out. Possibly Pomona or Point Loma may come out if East Bay wins today. So I'm sure Pomona may not want East Bay to win, because if East Bay wins, Pomona's season could be over as well.
Coming into this weekend, the Pioneers, since their move to the CCAA from Division III, have won 0 postseason games in any sport and 0 titles in the CCAA. Will that change today? We will find out. What are some keys to this matchup?
The first key you want to look at, the last 2 times they played one another, East Bay has been behind by a great deal. Cal State Dominguez Hill averages 41 points in the first half, so East Bay's been playing behind. So if they can keep the game even at the first half, they have a good chance, because in the second half, they have been playing extremely well against Dominguez Hills. It's the first half. Can East Bay play to their potential as they did yesterday?
As you mentioned, first half was key in both regular season matchups. Dominguez Hills scoring over 40 points in both first halves in the regular season meetings, but it's the postseason. It's one game. It's 40 minutes to decide the CCAA tournament champion. And we're about ready for tip-off here. Pioneers with some great support. The Toros also with some nice support on the opposite sideline. We're about ready for tip between the 1-seeded Toros of Dominguez Hills and the 6-seeded Pioneers of Cal State East Bay. It's Brashears and Jimenez wins the tip.
Look for Talia Rafford to have a big game. She's been solid, but the key matchups again is going to be Lopez, what she's able to do. But Remy Pujo, again, is going to be a key component in this game.
The jumper by Champion is off, and it's rebounded by Brashears, now Bland with it.
Goodenbauer is trying to get Taylor Champion off early, give some easy looks. Maybe she can get her some shots early in the shot clock.
On the floor to start the game for the Pioneers is Bland, Pujo, Brashears, Walker, and Lopez. The usual starting five. And they'll be relied on heavily in this one. Now here's Champion.
Remember the last time they played, Breezy Garcia and Lopez had plus 25 points in that game. So that's going to be a key one-on-one matchup tonight.
That huge matchup in Carson. Here's a jumper by Monet Lee. She knocks that down for the first basket of the game, and it's a 2-0 lead for the Toros.
We talked about Monet Lee being the X factor. She comes right out, hits a short jumper at the pinch post.
Here's Walker, the senior in her 4th year with the team, looking to extend her career one more day. There's Pujo, grabs her own rebound, goes up, grabs her own rebound again, and it eventually falls to Monet Lee.
You know, I've been singing praise about Pujo. She needs to make that shot. Those are those putbacks we talk about.
Jimenez under the basket, matched up with Pujo. Ball stays with the Toros.
Every point is going to be important in this game, and Cal State East Bay has to make those shots under the basket. They don't want to get down by too much in the first half as they have in the last 2 ball games.
As you recall, if you joined us yesterday, it was a 21-1 run to start the game by CSU East Bay. Answered quickly by Humboldt State, who went on a 24-4 run. Will we see swings like that in this game? Unlikely, but it is going to be a close matchup. There's a drive by Jimenez, rebounded by Pujo. Now here's Shannon Bland.
Brashears need to have a big game as well, Eric.
Brashears and Pujo in the post will be critical. Ball bounces around, eventually recovered by Garcia on a fast break.
Remember last game, Garcia had over 25 points against East Bay.
Jimenez unable to convert on the rebound of the Monet Lee shot and picked up by Brashears. Now Walker with space. Walker, the senior, makes it a tie ball game.
Excellent job by Maya Walker getting down the floor for the early outlet. Early transition offense could be the key to today's game.
Talia Rayford settles it. Screen set, had an open jumper, decides to bring it down. Now Monet Lee inside to Jimenez. Jimenez matched up with Puo, a big block by Remy Puo, the sophomore out of Hayward.
Look for Lopez to go right to the rim here.
Lopez tries to take it the whole way. Ball bounces around and it'll go to the Toros.
17 minutes left in the first half. It's been an evenly fought game so far, Eric. First substitution comes in the game for East Bay.
One of the players to watch, Lacey Effenberger, who's had a fantastic tournament so far.
Effenberger's been huge. A couple of threes in the last couple of ball games. That's another one of those X factors that stepped up big.
17 minutes left, 2-2 ball game. Here's Rayford, matched up with Stephanie Lopez. Kylan Wilson finds Breanne Garcia. Breezy finds Monet Lee from three. That's off. Good rebound by Champion in the post. She finishes, and it's a 4-2 lead.
That's something that's not what Champion normally does. She likes to play around the perimeter, but her size can be effective by getting rebounds.
Now here's Tori Brashears, matched up with Monet Lee. Effenberger. Effenberger. Pass to Lopez. Lopez to Walker. Walker makes some space for herself. Can't finish, though. Good rebound by Monet Lee.
Looked like the officials are letting them play a little bit, Eric.
Physical in the low post. Rayford settles again. Now Garcia. Rayford. Back out to Rayford, shot clock at 7.
Rayford isn't comfortable playing on the perimeter. She likes to drive to the rim.
Rayford in and out, grabbed by Brashear. She's got a few key early rebounds.
We talk about Effenberger. Effenberger's averaging 13 points a game, Eric, in the last two. She's been huge off the bench.
Littleton is checked in. Here's a pass to Puo, to Brashear, and she draws the foul. She'll go to the line.
Excellent entry pass yesterday, remember. Coach Barker was barking at our players for trying to force the ball inside. Great entry pass with a foul for Brashears. She'll be shooting two.
15:36 left in the first half. It's a 4-2 lead for the Toros. A physical defensive matchup to start. And as we're at our first media timeout, Coach, do you look for that to continue? Do you look for this to be more of a defensive matchup than a high-flying matchup that we kind of expected going into the game, Pioneers versus Jacks yesterday?
I think so because, again, we spoke about it earlier, if East Bay can keep the game close in the first half, they've been playing well against Dominguez in the second half. The second game, they were actually led in the second half, had more points in the second half. First game, they was even. The key for East Bay is to establish themselves. Don't get down too early, but East Bay is playing for a bid. They want to be dancing in March. They're not tired right now. They're playing for the end of the season. These seniors out there, Michael Walker, she's been there, Stephanie Lopez, these kids know what it takes. You don't get these opportunities so often. This is their chance. They don't want to leave it on the table.
Yeah, when looking at Dominguez Hills roster, a lot of seniors, a lot of juniors, but they're going to the tournament regardless. For East Bay players, Stephanie Lopez, Charissa Estramera, Alyssa Palma, and Micah Walker, a win today would mean they can extend their college careers one more game.
They can do it simply because they've watching the team that did it before them. Dominguez took the same route to the tournament, winning three games and winning the championship.
The Pioneers knocked off Pomona earlier in this tournament. Pomona, if I remember correctly, made it to the Division II Final Four last year.
They made it to the Final Four, exactly.
Here's another storyline. Here's Brashears, who hits both. 4-4 here with 15:36 remaining in the first.
East Bay is hot, Eric. They've beaten Humboldt, Pomona. They have a chance against Dominguez. All three are in the Western region.
This is a big game. Foul going to be called on Littleton. as I said before, if you look at the statistics across all sports, Cal State Dominguez Hills has won 35 CCAA titles. The Pioneers have yet to register one, so a huge game in program history and really in East Bay athletics history.
This is a huge game in building a culture of the program, getting kids to want to come and participate at East Bay. Coach Barkham has done an excellent job of establishing East Bay as a contender in the CCAA 2A conference.
Here's Garcia. For those of you just tuning in, Dominguez Hills in white going from right to left as you see it. Pioneers in all red going left to right. Champion hits the deck. Pass out, three ball. That's good. That's Anandi Jimenez.
Anytime you get your four man and can step out to hit the tray ball, that's added benefit for you.
So Jimenez with the three. Brashears will make it to the line.
Brashears is very aggressive this game. If she can stay on the floor, she's been having foul trouble the last two games, but she's being very aggressive on the offensive end. She understands that she needs to have a big game too for this team to move forward.
Brashears and Lopez have carried the team all year. We'll see if that can continue. 14:45 remaining in the first half. Low scoring game here, 7-5. Good physical defense.
Both teams are shooting a low shooting percentage. East Bay at 14%. Dominguez Hills at 20%.
A good sign for the Pioneers. Brashears 4-4 from the line so far. Here's Rayford. And now Champion matched up with Walker. Now Garcia drives into the lane. She's got nowhere to go. Ball loose, picked up by Jimenez, and the foul.
That's huge for Jimenez. That's 5 points with a chance for an and one. These are the players you don't think about to have a big game. She has an opportunity to make her mark right now with 6 points early in the first half with 14:30 left.
So Jimenez, the 5'11 junior out of Santa Rosa. Chance to have a big game in one of the bigger games of her career as she's got 6 early points. Here's Shannon Bland. Nice atmosphere here in Stockton. A couple of good groups of fans cheering on their teams in this huge game. Travel called. 14:17 left. It's a 10-6 lead for the Toros, coach.
East Bay has to be careful, Eric. They can't fall behind too far. They're down 10-6. They need a stop on the defensive end.
And timeout called by the official.
If I'm Coach Barkham right now, Eric, I'm excited because I'm still in the game. I'm not too far behind. Both teams are shooting low shooting percentages, maybe tired, but East Bay has played, this is their third game, 120 minutes in three games, whereas this is the 80th minute in terms of games for East for Dominguez Hills. So East Bay is fatigued, but that goes out the window right now.
Yeah, you know they're running on adrenaline, knowing that they have a chance to do something unprecedented. There's a pass into the low post, a little too high for Jimenez. And that's a turnover by Lee. Pioneer ball.
That's an excellent job of defense by Brashears. Her athleticism can match up with Monet Lee.
Now Stephanie Lopez, the outstanding senior guard. Walker looking for an avenue. Lopez thought about shooting from three, finds Walker. Shot clock at 9. It'll be inbounded under the basket. 13:38 left in the first.
I agree, Eric. Great atmosphere. Here are those baseline plays we talked about earlier. Can I steal 6 points out of these plays? That could be the difference between winning and losing basketball games.
Kylan Wilson checks in for Jimenez. Lopez under the basket. Finds Puo. Oh, but she can't hang on to the ball. Finishes with the left hand, however. That's a big shot there, Coach.
You know, I've been singing the praise of Remy Pooh. I'm going to start calling her Remy the Pooh because she's an excellent basketball player. She's going to be very good for East Bay for several years.
She has been a big factor in this tournament. providing some quality minutes alongside Lacey Effenberger. There's a shot off, rebounded by Walker. And now Bland almost lost the handles, but regains possession. Walker with an open jumper. That one's off, but Puo there for the rebound. Fresh shot clock for the Pioneers.
Excellent job. The reset. Run your offense. Possessions matter here.
Walker. The senior playing in one of the big games in Pioneer history. A great moment for her. Pass to Puo. Puo in the post. Tried to finish high off the glass. Good rebound there by Kylan Wilson.
Remy had it early. She pulled it back down. She went up strong at first. She had a layup.
Garcia and travel.
They're doing a good job. Garcia, I don't believe she's scored yet in the first half. Remember last game, she had over 25 points in the second game against Dominguez, against East Bay. So that's a good sign for East Bay's defense so far.
Yeah, in the matchup in Carson, she had 26 points. In the matchup in Hayward, she had 9 to go with 5 assists. So if they can neutralize Garcia, that'll help. That's a difficult shot for Lopez to make. Good rebound by Littleton.
Second chance opportunities is always huge.
Brashears matched up with Wilson. Foul called.
Tori Brashears is playing possessed right now, Eric. That's her third time going to the free throw line so far. She is playing possessed right now. She wants to play on.
Brashears definitely one of the most talented players that the Pioneers have had in recent years. And you can tell she wants to try to carry this team to the next level. That's her first missed free throw tonight. She's 4 of 5.
Remember, Eric, we talked about the three areas, layups, putbacks, and free throws. These opportunities to score, you need to take advantage of them.
Hits the second. Puo checks in for Brashears. 12 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the first half. It's a 10-9 ball game in favor of Dominguez Hills.
Champion will be checking in the next day at ball for Dominguez. They've done a great job on Rayford as well. Yesterday she had a huge game. Garcia and Rayford's under control.
Lee from three, and that's a nice shot. Ramone Lee, the junior out of Huntington Beach.
That's a shot she's developed over the years, Eric. Now she has the opportunity to shoot the three ball. She becomes more difficult to guard.
Effenberger finds Palma, Alyssa Palma, who had a couple big threes earlier in the tournament. That shot's off. Good rebound by Puo. Puo goes up, but she's rejected by the combination of Jimenez and Rayford.
This is a nice defensive game right now, Eric.
11 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first. Here's a drive, and that's smooth from Janae Gooden.
I think that's Janae Gooden's first basket in the tournament. Look for Lopez to get to the rim.
Can't get it to go. And it's a nice little stretch here, a 5-0 run for the Toros.
Eric, Lopez looked like she's pressing a little bit right now. She has to let the game come to her. That's when she's at her best.
Rayford now. Garcia back to Rayford. Shot clock at 2. Good defense by the Pioneers as Palma dives on it and is able to find Lopez. Now Lopez. Still Lopez. Oh, and she almost was able to have a chance at an and one, but she will go to the line.
Lopez is their best offensive player. She's trying to be aggressive. Sometimes players need to see the ball go through the basket, Eric. That's what she's trying to do. These two free throws is huge to get her going. I like what East Bay's doing. They're keeping the game close. They're playing solid defense. They're controlling the best player scores for Dominguez, which is Garcia and Rayford. They're doing a great job right now. Lee is making some shots. You got to give up the three. It's okay. When your big's hitting the three, they're two bigs. Jimenez and Lee has hit tray balls. Outside of that, they have everyone else under control.
10:28 left in the first half of the CCAA Women's Basketball Championship. It's a 15-9 lead for the Toros. Good contingent of East Bay fans, good contingent of Toro fans here. Should be a nice atmosphere, and we do have the men's championship game coming up for you at 7:30. Chico State, the number one seed in that matchup, looking to complete the double of winning both the regular season and postseason crowns. We'll have that for you here on GoCCAA.org.
Let's see if East Bay on these two free throws change the tempo. Coach Barkham usually comes with some sort of trap full court. This would be a great opportunity right now to change the tempo, see if they get a quick turnover for a layup.
It's a six-point lead for the Toros. Lopez at the line. Lopez does not miss often from the free throw line.
East Bay is doing a great job of knocking down their free throws. They're scoring most of their baskets from the free throw line. That means they're being aggressive going to the rim.
Misses the second. 15-10, the score. Monet Lee drives, knocked away, but a weird bounce off Effenberger, and it'll remain with the Toros.
Currently, Eric, East Bay is shooting 14%, 2 for 14 from the floor. Dominguez Hills then ramped it up a little bit. They're shooting 6 for 15 for 40%. East Bay is 5 for 6 from the free throw line.
It's been Dominguez Hills' game early on. Pioneers hanging tough, though, in what's been a good physical matchup here in the first half. 10 minutes remaining in the first. Offensive foul. Pioneer ball. A drive by Jimenez.
That's a great job by Brashears. Anytime you see a foul with Brashears, you hold your breath because you don't know it's going to be a defensive foul, but luckily enough, that was an offensive foul.
Brashears fouled out in the first game. Lopez fouled out in the second game. The Pioneers were able to win both, showing how this team can battle. Here's Effenberger. Now Walker, top of the key. Inside pass to Brashears. Double teamed. Out to Bland. That one's off. Rebounded by Jimenez. Foul on Walker.
Walker's being aggressive. Thought she can catch the ball. Here's some sort of press right now. Barkham called a press, but they didn't get into the press.
Kylan Wilson back into the game.
East Bay has to shoot better from the floor, Eric. They're 2 for 14 right now. They can start making some shots because they're aggressive. They're getting to the line. They got to start making some shots from the floor.
Still just a five-point game. Chance for Dominguez Hills to extend the lead. Here's Taylor Champion with a jumper. Contested jumper rebounded by Littleton.
Early transition offense.
Effenberger drives. Now back out. Inside pass to Brashears. Easy money for Torrey Brashears. He's having a nice ball game, Coach.
As I said, Eric, Brashears is focused. This is her best game so far in the two games in the tournament.
The chant of defense from the Pioneer faithful. Champion finds Rayford. Matched up with Brashears. Screen set. Rayford. That's a low percentage shot, and it'll be a Pioneer ball.
That's great defense. Excellent job on the ball screen. They hedged really hard. Brashears has 7 points so far. She's the leading scorer. Out of the 9 points, 12 points East Bay has, Brashears has seven.
And Brashears having a big game. Lopez checks in. Lopez to Bland. Brashears in the post. Ball kicked. It'll remain with the Pioneers. 8:34 left. Score is 15-12, Toros.
Coach Barker must believe they can win this matchup in the post. They're feeding everything in the post to Brashears and Pujo.
Set play under the basket. Effenberger receives the pass from Bland, trying to create something for herself. Into Lopez. Unable to finish, but brought down by Brashears, who makes it a one-point ball game.
Brashears is on fire right now. She's single-handedly keeping East Bay in this game. Once Lopez gets going, they're going to be a tough handle.
Here's Gooden. Off-ball foul.
Eric, this game definitely feels like a home game for East Bay.
It's definitely a shorter distance to Stockton from East Bay than it is from Carson, California, but Pioneers have been well supported throughout this whole tournament and a good crowd for the Toros as well. But when the Pioneers make a basket or make a defensive stop, it can get pretty loud here in the Stockton Arena. Rayford, now Garcia. Garcia looking to get something started. That's off, rebounded by Walker.
Great challenge on the shot by Brashears.
Lopez coast to coast, and the Pioneers are in the lead.
I'm sure Molly Goodenbar is going to talk about that. Lopez wants to go coast to coast, transition basketball. That was a great job.
So the Pioneers once trailed by six. They erased that deficit and they lead 16-15 at this media timeout. Coach, it's been a few swings back and forth like we've seen in every game in this tournament. What a fantastic CCAA tournament it's been here in Stockton. What do you look for Coach Molly Goodenbauer to say after blowing that 5-point lead so quickly?
Well, I think what's happening is that East Bay is playing, doing such a tremendous job playing defense. And what they've done, they focused on not letting their stars beat them. We talked about Garcia, talk about Rafer. You look at their stat line, Monet Lee is leading them in scoring. I'm sorry, Jimenez is leading them scoring with 6 points. Champion has two. Breezy has no points so far, and Monet Lee, five. If you'd have told me at the seven-minute mark that Garcia has no points, I would say, are you crazy? Because she is one of the better players, so they've done a great job of taking her out of the game, forcing other players to beat them, something that they're not used to doing.
Garcia and Rayford both not on the score sheet yet, which is amazing. This matchup, you would think, maybe before the game, Coach Barkham emphasized trying to shut down Garcia after that 26-point outburst in Carson a few weeks ago.
Exactly. Basically, she's saying these two players can't beat us. Make somebody else beat us, and that's exactly what they're doing.
Here's Lee. Now Rayford matched up with Lopez. Garcia step back. Now pass down low to Lee. Jumper for Lee, and that's her bread and butter shot right there.
We talked about Monet Lee as an X factor in the game. You see why, Eric. She has the ability to score big.
Effenberger from way out. Ball stays with the Pioneers.
You can't get mad at that shot by Effenberger. She's averaging 13.5 points in two games, so she's been hot from the tray line.
Effenberger been solid from beyond the arc in the two games in this tournament. Inbounded to Effenberger again. Tries another one. That one's short. Brought down by Rayford. Coast-to-coast opportunity. Rayford. And foul called on Brashears.
That's a good call. Gooden gave her a rocker step and got to the rim. Brashears moved her feet, but a lot of contact for the foul. Look for Remy DePoo to come back into the game.
So Brashears on two fouls with seven remaining in the first. Inbounded to Lee, who finds Rayford.
Dominguez Hill has four turnovers so far in the game, to East Bay having two.
Rayford inside pass to Champion. Champion the jumper. That's off. In and out. Brought down by Walker. Still a one-point game. Lopez the jumper. Easy money for one of the best guards in this conference, one of the best players in this conference, and the Pioneers retake the lead.
Lopez is one of the top five players in the conference this year. Great defense.
Shot off, brought down by Walker again. Lopez again! And the Pioneers open up their largest lead of the night. It's 20-17 with 6 minutes and change left in the first.
We talked about Stephanie Lopez has the ability to take a game over. Now her and Brashears are asserting themselves.
Garcia with an opportunity. She'll go to the line, fouled by Effenberger.
Excellent job by Stephanie Lopez. The six-minute mark. East Bay has the lead by three, their biggest lead so far. Lopez is starting to assert herself.
You look, we're 6 minutes away from halftime. Brashears with 5 rebounds and Pua with 6 already. Garcia hits the first. Substitutions for the Pioneers. Littleton and Palma come in. Jimenez comes in for Dominguez Hills.
One thing that makes Stephanie Lopez so difficult, because she can grab the ball and go coast to coast, but she's such a bigger guard than most guards in our conference. She has the ability to score inside over smaller guards, and once she gets her head of steam going, she's difficult to stop.
Yeah, Lopez has everything. She has the experience, the size, the speed, and the shot. We'll see if she can carry her team one more time. Oh, a tough pass there, trying to find Effenberger, stolen by Jimenez, and she takes it coast to coast, and the Toros re-grab the lead.
Live ball turnovers there, if we talked about that.
Effenberger deeks, pass to Littleton, who takes it back out.
That's a great job by Effenberger to get inside in the teeth of the defense.
Cross-court pass, Shannon Bland. Bland into the lane, Effenberger from three. That's money from the Alaskan product.
Effenberger's been solid in this tournament. She's their unsung hero. If they do advance further, you have to use her as an unsung hero, Eric. She's been solid.
Drive into the lane by Rayford. Eventually recovered by Lee. Good physical contact down low, and the ball falls to Lee.
4:50 left in the first half, Eric, and East Bay has the lead right now.
Looks to be another game that may come down to the final 2 minutes, as you say. Champion able to keep it in. That's an alert play and a great basket there. The interchange between Champion and Rayford.
Excellent job. That's Rayford's first basket today.
Bland. Now Effenberger coming off that big three. Never afraid to shoot, Lacey Effenberger. Now Shannon Bland tries to bank one in. Rebound brought down by Jimenez. 4 minutes and 15 seconds left in the first. Rayford from beyond the arc. Big shot by Talia Rayford. Timeout, Pioneers.
That's 5 points with Rayford in the last two possessions. He's starting to get loose.
Rayford had a donut in the scoring category earlier. She's now at 5. She's starting to take over and bring her presence into this game.
East Bay was up by 3 with that free throw. Now Dominguez Hills came right back. Now they're up by 3 at the 4-minute mark. That shows what a champion does, but don't count East Bay out right now.
Swings of possession, swings of the lead. And as of right now, with 4 minutes and 8 seconds left in the first half, the Toros lead 26-23. Definitely going to be another one of those maybe first to 64, Coach? Maybe first to 60?
And this one may go, with the way they're playing defense right now, it could be a first to 60 game. I'm sure that East Bay is looking at it as, if we can keep the game in the 60, we have an excellent opportunity to win. Dominguez Hill wants to get up and down the floor, wants to score 60 to 75 to 70 points. So right now, East Bay is doing a great job of keeping them close to contact, because remember the first two games we talked about, Dominguez Hill scored over 41 points, and East Bay was playing behind in both of those ball games, which is difficult to make up against a good team like Dominguez Hill.
Out of the media timeout, it's Puo, Bland, Lopez, Walker, and Effenberger for the Pioneers. Gooden, Garcia, Rayford, Lee, and Hudson for Dominguez Hills. Effenberger with it. Just under 4 minutes left in the first half. Now the senior, Michael Walker. Back to Walker. Lopez, shot clock at 8. Jumper by Lopez. That's off, but she gets her own rebound. Effenberger to tie it. And she knocks it down. 26-26.
Effenberger is on fire again. She has been the unsung hero, Eric. If they do advance on, she has to be considered as one of the key ingredients for that to happen.
She's now hit multiple threes in each of the 3 conference championship games. Jumper by Lee, And she answers right back.
That's an excellent job by Monet Lee. Remember, she's worked on that. She's improved her game in that area. That's two trays she's knocked down so far.
They give that as a long two travel called on Walker.
Back in for the Hills, number three.
Champion checks in. Pioneers shooting 32% from the floor, 37% for Dominguez Hill, so the gap narrowed a little bit, just as the score has.
Exactly.
3 minutes left in the first. Good pass to Monet Lee. Can't convert, though, and Walker brings the rebound down.
That's the play Dominguez Hill's run. It's called pinch, where they'll bump the post and they'll dive her down looking for the high-low.
And Effenberger draws the foul. They're going to call that one on Kylan Wilson. And for the first time today, the senior Sharissa Estramera checks in for Shannon Bland. Estramera does not play a lot of minutes, but she is absolutely capable of shooting the three ball.
Exactly.
Effenberger regains possession. Puo in the post. Stolen by Lee. Nice defensive play. And then grabbed by Estramera. But the jump ball favors the Toros.
She's making her presence felt already, coming in for a tie-up.
2-point lead for the Toros with 2:30 remaining in the first half. And they have possession.
East Bay needs a stop here. It's all about confidence right now, Eric. It's all about confidence.
We'll see if the halftime score will be as close as it seems it'll be right now. It's always been close throughout this tournament. Here's Champion from three. And that is a big shot. Off front iron, off the glass and in, and a 5-point lead for the Toros.
That was an excellent shot fake. Relocate to shoot the ball by Champion.
Estramera finds Walker. Now back to Lopez. Lopez drives. Rejected by Champion. And the momentum squarely in the Toros corner. Champion again from three. That one's off, but it'll remain. Oh no, it'll go with the Pioneers. Looked like it may have come out off of Lopez, but ruled to be Pioneer ball.
Champion is starting to feel it right now. That shot was straight on and just rimmed in and out. East Bay needs to get a score here. They don't want to fall behind too far. As you mentioned, this is the first time they've been this close in two games, so that's positive for them, but they want to at least have the lead or be tired going into halftime.
Since the Pioneers joined the CCAA for the 09-10 season, there's Lopez with a three. Just to finish that thought, the Pioneers are 3-10 all time against Dominguez Hills, so a win today would be against some significant odds. Lopez brings it to a 2-point game with that big three.
Big-time players, Eric, step up in big-time plays.
Pioneer ball.
Dominguez Hill, Eric, is running a zipper screen for Garcia on a zipper, and they're giving her a ball screen across the top. Great job on that time for East Bay.
1 minute remaining here in the title game of the 2015 CCAA Women's Basketball Championship. And wouldn't you believe it, it's another fantastic game, as all of them have been here. Lopez will go to the line, and she's pumped up with a chance to tie this game at 31.
Eric, the last two games, East Bay has led at halftime. The last two games, this is a great opportunity for them. They're 2-0 so far when they're leading at halftime. If they can lead at half, I like their chances. I'm sure they'll be confident knowing that they can play with Dominguez Hills.
They won against Pomona in comeback fashion. They won yesterday after having a 20-point lead, losing it, and then coming back at the end. Can the Pioneers find another way to win today? Here's Lopez to try to tie it up. And she does, 31-31 with 49.3 left in the first half. Here's Rayford.
East Bay will get the last shot unless Dominguez go 2-for-1.
Rayford with some space. That's an easy basket for her. Good play design there. Long pass, that's an ill-advised pass by Bland.
Eric, you didn't need that. You had the last shot of the half. Want to get a good shot, you can go in at least tied. Now they have to play solid defense. They don't want to go in behind by too much.
As we tick down towards 15 seconds remaining in the first half, it's Garcia slowing it down. 33-31, the Toros lead.
If East Bay had a foul to give, they'll take it, but they have no fouls to give.
Rayford. That's off. Maybe a chance at a prayer here by Walker. No, not enough time. So a solid first half here in Stockton. The Toros go into halftime leading 33-31. Coach, what was the story of the first half? Really close game. Good battle by the Pioneers against the higher-seeded Toros. What do you look for in the second half, and what did you see in the first half?
The first half, I seen East Bay fighting for their lives. I seen them having a lot of passion. I seen that they feel confident what they did. They took the two halves of the first two games and said, hey, we can play with these guys. Let's get rid of the first half of the first two games, and they've been able to do that successfully. Dominguez Hills, on the other hand, they know they've done this before. They know exactly what it takes. I've talked to their coaches before the game. They're not taking East Bay lightly because Dominguez Hill last year won those three games to get to the championship. They beat Pomona in the final. So they understand what it takes. They're not looking at East Bay lightly at all. East Bay actually has a chance to get this done. These next 20 minutes are going to be critical in their season.
A huge 20 minutes of basketball to bring you after the break here at the Stockton Arena. It's halftime. It's 33-31. The Toros lead the Pioneers. We'll be right back with coverage of the Women's CCAA Basketball Championship. All right, Coach, we're out of the halftime locker room. Just got to look at the halftime stats. What are some points of emphasis from that first half, and what do you look for in the second half?
Well, as the score indicates, Eric, they're pretty even. Both teams are shooting 34-35%. Points in the paint is 12-12. Points off turnovers, Dominguez 7-6. Second chance points, Dominguez 7-6. Fast break, East Bay is 4-2. The bench has been better for East Bay, 6+4, 6-2. So it's a pretty evenly matched game. The stats indicate that.
No matter where you look on the stat sheet, everything's relatively close. This is a really tight ball game, as the score indicates. 33-31 as we start the second half here in Stockton, the second half of the CCAA Women's Basketball Championship game. Dominguez Hills won the regular season title. East Bay looking to snag a spot in the NCAA Division II Championship.
Let's see if Lopez continued that hot half she had.
So the Pioneers come out with their typical starting five. Here's Puo in the low post. Tries to get it started, but the rebound brought down by Champion. Good rebound.
You see the emphasis all night has been inside.
Monet Lee. That's money from Monet.
Pointed out Monet Lee as an X factor before the game. She's living up to the billing right now.
4-point lead for the Toros. Here's Micah Walker, the senior. Now Brashears matched up with Garcia.
This is where Brashears need to develop another piece to her game.
Lopez grabs her own rebound and finishes.
Brashears had Breezy guarding her at the perimeter. She needs to take her off the dribble.
That's now 14 points for Stephanie Lopez. 14 points, 2 boards, 3 assists. Excuse me, 3 boards and 3 assists. Now Garcia. Lee drives, jumper. That's off, rebounded by Lopez. Pioneers up the floor with Lopez. Spin into the lane, silky move, and she'll get to the line.
Lopez is putting her imprint on this game, Eric. She understands this may be her last time ever putting on a college uniform, so she's playing extremely hard. Who they need is Michael Walker needs to step up and give him some points. She only has 2 points so far. Walker needs to step up for her final game if she wants to move on to next week.
Effenberger with 6, Brashears with 9 to go with Lopez's now 15. Lee led in scoring in the first half with 9, Jimenez with 8. So it's a tie ball game yet again, 35-35 with 18:39 remaining in the women's CCAA championship game. Foul called on Brashears.
Touch foul on Brashears on the drive to the rim. Monet Lee is having a great game. Brashears had to close out because she's been shooting a 3-ball on her, so she took advantage of that and drove it to the rim.
That's now 3 fouls on Brashears with 18:30 left. A situation to monitor.
That's a play that Dominguez runs a lot, Eric. It's called pinch, where they'll bump the post and go right back at us looking for an isolation down low.
Talia Rayford finds Brian Garcia. Tough pass to snag, but Champion brings it down. Now a drive by Garcia. That's a tough shot. And she knocks it down. Big play by Brianne Garcia to give the Toros the lead.
Littlest player on the floor. Biggest heart.
Lopez answers, and she is on fire here to start the second half.
That's a great no call, Eric. Great no call.
Ball hit the underside of the backboard, and it'll be Pioneer ball. 37-37. It's Garcia and Rayford against Stephanie Lopez here at the start of this second half.
Eric, who is going to step up for East Bay? Who's going to give them more points? It's only right now it's just Lopez.
Maybe Micah Walker as she drives into the lane at off the back iron. Walker and Effenberger, maybe where I would look here in the second half, maybe Remy Puo. With Brashears now on three fouls, here's Lopez. Palma from three, the senior can't get it to go. That's corralled there by Rayford, excuse me, coach.
That's a great look, Eric, just rimmed out.
Foul called. And she'll go to the line for two, basket does not count.
They counted the basket, Eric. They did count the basket.
They did count the basket. 39-37, a chance to make it a three-point game. Rayford having a strong last few minutes after a slow start. She's really kicked it into high gear here in the second half.
I agree. Dominguez Hill's scoring is much more balanced than East Bay's scoring. You have Champion, Jimenez, Garcia, Rayford, and Lee, all who are scoring. East Bay, pretty much, it's been the Stephanie Lopez show.
And that's to be expected. The Pioneers leader, not only is she a senior and one of the best players in the conference, but she is the team leader. Here's Lopez to Effenberger. Effenberger with room, unable to get that one to go, and now a fast break opportunity. And Garcia will convert. 42-37, a five-point lead for the Toros.
16:34 left. Coach Barker may want to call a timeout to regroup with her team, or she may be waiting for the next media on the next dead ball.
No look pass to Walker now. Effenberger into the lane. Littleton rejected, shot clock at 14. Pioneers will inbound under the basket with 16:19 remaining.
Coach Barkham has no choice right now to insert Tori Brashears back into the game.
Effenberger will inbound it, looking for an avenue, gets it to Palma. Now Walker. Shot clock at six. Brashears with the runner. Can't get that one to go. And the Pioneers on the ropes here as Garcia goes coast to coast. And it'll stay with the Toros, last out off of Walker.
The second half, Cal State Dominguez Hills, they've pushed up the tempo. They're out in transition, Eric.
It'll be inbounded. Stolen by Lopez, big steal there by Steph. Now Michael Walker on the other end. And that's huge. Walker with a fast break opportunity, can't convert. Media timeout. It's a five-point lead for the Toros. Why have the Toros come out flying here in the second half, Coach?
Well, they understand that they have a chance to win this basketball game, and they don't want to give East Bay any opportunity to win. Although Dominguez Hills is a shoe-in to the tournament, they still have pride, too. Dominguez Hills has an opportunity to do something that hasn't been done in quite some time, win the conference championship back-to-back. It's usually a different person, different team each year. Dominguez Hills has the opportunity to do it back-to-back.
Dominguez Hills looking for that back-to-back title. Pioneers looking for their first title and their first trip to the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship. 15:52 left in the second half. What's something you look maybe for Coach Susie Barkham to tell her team here, maybe a shift in strategy?
I look for them to use their full court press if they can to try to change the tempo of the game. What they can do is go back into a zone as well too to try to change, give them a different look, because right now Dominguez Hills is comfortable at what they're doing. They're running their offense pretty much on made runouts, that's what they're doing. So they don't have to do something to change the look, but someone else has to step up and play because it's all about Stephanie Lopez right now. Brashears has three fouls. I'm looking at Michael Walker. This is our opportunity to put an imprint on this game.
We saw in the East Bay versus Cal Poly Pomona game that full court press work effectively for the Pioneers. Looks like they will go back to it. Talia Rayford.
just as I thought they would do, Eric. They went to their zone defense to try to give them a different look.
Rayford from three. Tried to bank that one in. Rebound by Palma, the senior.
As a coach, Eric, you have to change the looks from time to time. They got to stop there. Made go back to it on a made free throw or made bucket here.
Lopez, as always, driving into the lane. And that ball will stay with the Pioneers. As you've said, Coach, it's been all Lopez here in the second half. She's up to 18 points for the Pioneers, but they do need scoring from some other sources.
Exactly. If you look at Dominguez Hill, they have two players with double figures so far, with Mendez 2 points away from being a third player with double figures.
Effenberger in the corner. Lopez from three. That's off. Rebounded by Rayford. Still a five-point lead for the Toros with 15 minutes remaining in the title game. Jimenez back to Rayford.
They're matching up from player to player on defense.
Jimenez drives, and she draws the foul. She'll go to the line.
We've seen yesterday, Eric, every time Jimenez gets the ball, she drives to the left side, so maybe they need to jump on her left hip and force her to the right side because it looks as though she's not comfortable going right. Everything is going left.
And Lopez looks to be a little shaken up.
I'm sure
she goes to the sidelines for just a minute.
Yes, I'm sure it's going to be a short timeout for her.
We saw yesterday the Pioneers were able to close that game out without Lopez, but needless to say, they would love to have her on the floor in one of the big games in program history. She's getting checked out by the trainer. Jimenez hits both, and that's a 7-point lead for the Toros, their biggest since early in the first half.
Eric, this game can get away from Cal State East Bay. They have to get a stop and a score.
Brashears back in on three fouls. Now Remy Puo. Remy can't get it to go, but it falls to Shannon Bland. Walker, the senior. Brashears. Effenberger. They're taking away the three-point shot, Coach.
Exactly, and this is why I was saying that Brashears need to develop another piece to the game because they're backing off of her as she catches the ball because they know she wants to drive the ball. If she can shoot the ball, they'll come out and guard her. So Brashears is not effective away from the free throw line but inside the paint. She needs to do that to evolve herself as a player next year.
It'll be inbounded by Shannon Bland, 14-11 remaining, 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Here's Walker. Now Effenberger, shot clock down to five. Effenberger to Puo, but that's intercepted and stolen by Kylan Wilson.
They lost recognition on the shot clock, Eric. That's a turnover.
Monet Lee. Now Jimenez. Jimenez matched up with Brashears. Chance for Kylan Wilson on the drive. Pass down low. That's easy money for Anandi Jimenez, who's been one of the stars of this game.
She's had a great tournament as well. This game is starting to get away from East Bay. They need a bucket in a big way.
Puo will get to the line. The Pioneers needed that as they trail by nine with 13:25 left.
They go inside to Remy to Puo. Hopefully she can knock down these two free throws, Eric.
We've been saying throughout this tournament, Puo, a player to watch in the coming years in the CCAA. You think she has the potential to be one of the best players in this conference?
I do, Eric. She's young, so this is a big step for her. Last year, she didn't play as many minutes. This year, she's a big-time player for them. Look for her junior year to be really good. I think she can be the player of the year by her senior year if she put the work in.
Had a chance to interview her after the game yesterday, and safe to say there's nobody more excited about being in this game than Remy. Knocks down the second free throw, and it's a 7-point deficit for the Pioneers. Puo checks out with Littleton coming in. Estramera on the floor as well, the senior.
There's the pinch play. They're going to go post up hard. There should be a hard double on her right there, Eric.
Jimenez goes for it. Good rebound by Champion, who'll get to the line.
When they run that pinch play, Eric, what they could do is if it's a non-shooter entering the pass, they can double down hard because Rafer doesn't really shoot the ball from the perimeter. They double hard down, force her to shoot the ball.
Champion converts the first. Coming in for the first time, Ashanti Sweezer.
Molly's going deep to her bench because Sweezer hasn't played in the last couple of games from what I recall.
Sweezer, the transfer from Ventura College. Her first appearance, I believe, in this tournament. Remains a 9-point lead. Tied for their largest of the night. Good move by Lopez to give herself some space. Stolen. And this game may be getting away from the Pioneers. They need to stop.
If they get a score here, I look for Coach Barkman to call a timeout.
Big possession here for Dominguez Hills. Champion Rayford. Now Monet Lee, shot clock at 10. Champion from three. That's off. Good rebound by Brashears. Bland.
Excellent job by stopping the ball by Gooden.
And I think they're going to change this one.
Yeah, that ball was deflected out. They're going to change the ball. It's going to be East Bay ball under the basket.
Pioneers maintain possession. Shot clock at 17. Michael Walker back into the game.
Eric, I can't stress it more. Michael Walker has 2 points in this game. She has to show up to give him a chance.
One of the team's leaders. She's going to be needed. Brashears misses the layup. She prefers the left-hander. Tried to go to the right side there. 48-39 with 12 minutes left. Dominguez Hills looking to take a commanding lead here. And they will, double digits. It's 50-39, and the Pioneers need a basket, and they need one quick.
You see the experience of Dominguez Hills now taking its form, Eric.
Inside pass to Brashears, looking for an avenue. Draws the foul, she'll go to the line. And the Pioneers need these free throws as the Toros look to be distancing themselves with 11:30 remaining.
If you look at the game, Eric, it's coming down to a few aspects you can point to here. Dominguez Hills, again, scoring balance is much better. You look at Dominguez Hills, you have Champion with five or more. Jimenez, she's scoring. Garcia scoring. Rayford and Monet Lee. Lee and Rayford has double digits. For East Bay, you only have Lopez with 18 points, where Brashears has a chance to get into double figures, but the scoring is not balanced. That's why East Bay is struggling. Dominguez Hills has more opportunities to score to the basket, where East Bay is only two players is really scoring for East Bay, and it's going to be difficult to win when you have two players playing against five.
Yeah, the Pioneers rely heavily on Lopez and Brashears. Right now, maybe leaning a little too heavily on their star players, needing contributions from other players to get back into this one as they trail by 11. It's been a great CCAA tournament here at the beautiful Stockton Arena. Pioneers, the sixth seed, the Cinderella, trying to cap off what's been an amazing run, but looks like Dominguez Hills holds the cards for now as they're trying to win back-to-back titles.
Dominguez Hills definitely showing their championship medal here.
Brashears at the line. Knocks down the first.
as a coach, Eric, you always tell your kids, let's get the game under 10 with 10 minutes left in the remaining. It gives us a chance, and they've been able to do that so far. So now they need a couple of stops and a couple of stores.
Pioneers came from 16 points down against Pomona to win. They came from 7 down against Humboldt to win. Now they're going to need to come from 12 down in this one with just over 11 minutes left.
That's Breezy's first three of the game. East Bay went to their 2-3 zone. They recognized it. Breezy was able to knock down the three.
That jumper by Brashears is off. Rayford able to get the pass to Jimenez. Jimenez unable to finish, though, brought down by Walker. Now Bland on a fast break finds Brashears. Brashears knocks it down. Timeout Pioneers, 53-43. With 10:45 remaining in this one. So, Coach, you were saying try to get it to under 10 with under 10 left.
Exactly. From a momentum standpoint, it allows you to tell the kids we're still in the game. It's 10 minutes left. We have it to 10. So only thing we need now is stops and conversion. Stops and conversion. Can we string together 2 to 3 stops and get 2 or 3 conversions? We're back in this game. So they're fine right now. I would imagine they may do a little 1-2-1-1 zone trap, change the tempo back into a zone again, but they have to change the tempo. Let's try to get a live ball turnover, get a layup under the basket. Now let's get easy buckets right now to get back into the game.
So with 10:45 left and a 10-point ball game, it would be a Herculean effort for the Pioneers to come back and win this one. But do you think they have what it takes to pull that off, given that they're leaning so heavily on Lopez and Brashears right now?
Well, it depends if someone else steps up. Effenberger, somebody has to give them more points. But you can't fault Effenberger. She's done her job, 2 for 4 from the three. But we need someone else. Michael Walker, Remy Puel needs to play better. Shannon Bland, she has no points right now. So these players need to step up. If they can give you 2 points, 4 points each, you have a chance. But right now, they're weighing heavily on two players.
That main point we keep hitting on, the balance of Dominguez Hills, is they have players with 7, 12, 6, 12, and 11. The Pioneers leaning heavily on their two stars. We'll see if Dominguez Hills can use some clock management to their advantage here. Ball sails out of bounds. As you say, live ball turnover. And maybe that's an opportunity for the Pioneers to grab some momentum.
Exactly. That's one turnover. That's one stop. Now, what could we do on the offensive end now? Can we convert? But they give the ball right back. Great defense by Rafer.
And they're going to call that on Lopez. So a tough, tough situation as the Pioneers earn themselves a turnover and then gave it right back. And now at the line is Rayford for two.
Eric, as a coach, you always tell your kids you don't want to do a turnover to a turnover. And so in that situation, you had a turnover, then you turn it all right back over, and it makes matters worse. Lopez fouls, doesn't want to give up the easy bucket, but if Rayford misses these two, then it's okay. It's like a turnover.
Lopez on two fouls, so not in foul trouble. Brashears at three. Full court press by Dominguez Hills. Now Effenberger drives, pass to Puo, ball out of bounds, it'll stay with the Pioneers.
Great idea, the ball was just knocked out of her hands.
Walker, and one, big shot by Walker, the senior. She doesn't want this to be the final game of her college career. And she'll go to the line to try to make it an 8-point game.
We talked about that. Those baseline plays, Eric, they're so huge in the game. If you can get 6 points to that a night, you're doing well. That's an excellent job. Here's a chance to get 3 points on this and one.
And she does, 8-point game.
8-point game, Eric, with 10:09 left. So they was able to accomplish the task of getting the lead under 10. So now they have a chance now to make some plays on the defensive end to get out and transition offensively.
With what's essentially a home crowd behind them, the Pioneers still face a huge challenge in trying to overcome this deficit as Monet Lee brings it right back to a double-digit lead.
Excellent shot by Monet Lee.
Here's Lacey Effenberger. the pride of Ketchikan, Alaska. Pass to Brashears, that's off, but rebounded by Littleton. Lopez takes it herself. That's almost an impossible basket.
They have her trapped in the backcourt. It's going to be a foul on Maya Walker. I think Michael Walker used her body. Eric, although the fans don't agree with the foul, it was a good foul. She rolled her body out of bounds.
It'll be inbounded by Wilson to Rayford. 9 minutes, 28 seconds left. 56-46. Dominguez Hills leads.
East Bay needs three consecutive possessions of turnovers. There's the first one right there, Eric. Although it wasn't a live ball turnover, it was an offensive turnover, so that's one stop right there. Now they need to get a couple more and a couple more buckets.
So the foul leads to a turnover. Good screen there by Puo. And now Lopez trying to take over and do it herself, and she gets this rally started. So the Pioneers convert on the turnover. Dominguez Hills trying to answer right back with Rayford. Do not want a foul here.
Look for Dominguez to try to run some offense, to try to get a score. Look for Jimenez. He's been big during the game.
Garcia from three. That's short, but recovered by Wilson. Alert play by Wilson. Shot clock at four. She's going to have to shoot from way out. That one's off, but rebounded by Champion. Foul called. And the Pioneer fans don't agree with it, but the Dominguez Hills fans love it. Champion to the line.
Second chance opportunities, Eric. They had a chance to secure that rebound, get out in transition. That could have kicked them down to six. Now they have a chance to go back up by 10 again. You got to grab every rebound. Every rebound is everything right now. You got to get every rebound. That's their fourth foul for Brashears.
Big story there. 8:33 left. Brashears on four fouls. Champion hits the first. Unable to hit the second, brought down by Walker. 9-point game. Pioneers would love a three ball here. Screen set by Walker. Effenberger from three. Big three from Lacey Effenberger. 6-point game, 57-51.
Eric, we talked about somebody stepping up. Effenberger again.
In the absence of Brashears, Effenberger, Puo, and Walker need to contribute in the final 8 minutes. There's a pass to Champion. Good work by Champion. Foul called, I believe, on Remy Puo.
Eric, they got to take Jimenez's left hand away. They've got to take her left hand away. She's getting what she wants because she's going left. You got to commend her for being able to do what she wants to do with the basketball.
Timeout on the floor. It's 57-51. Looks like Champion will go to the line when we return. 57-51. Not insurmountable, but a comfortable lead for Dominguez Hills, and they have possession.
They got the game down to six right now, Eric. So it's depending on these two free throws. They're still in contact, if you will. So if they can get some stops and scores, this game's going to come down to the last 3 minutes. You know Lopez is going to be there in the end. Now the question comes, when do I put Brashears back in the game? Do I put her in early like she did the first time when she fouled at the seven-minute mark? Do I wait later on now with the same mark right now at 7 minutes? I may want to wait till 4 minutes to bring her in, allowing her to finish the game off. I get her in too early, she fouls out. I don't have her to go to in the end.
So we'll see when Coach Barkham brings Brashears back in. Only foul trouble for Dominguez Hills is that Kylan Wilson is on four. It'll actually be Jimenez at the line, so Jimenez trying to extend the lead. 7:59 left. Swish on the first from Jimenez. Anandi Jimenez, the junior out of Santa Rosa, having a phenomenal game here in the title game.
Eric, that's her 14th point. That's her best game so far. With the question's been answered, Coach Barkham goes to Brashears now with four fouls at the seven-minute mark.
Some slick moves by Effenberger to find some space. Now she's in the corner. Almost lost it. Regains possession. Inside to Brashears. Got to be careful. Brashears high off the glass. Brought down by Rayford. Rayford matched up with Walker. Brought down by Lee. Good defense by the Pioneers.
Great defensive effort. Down by eight.
7:20 left in the CCAA championship game here at Stockton Arena. Here's Brianne Garcia. Breezy with it. That's a great play by Garcia to set up Jimenez, who will go to the line.
Jimenez has an opportunity to score his 15th and 16th point. This is the most points she's had in these two games. She has been huge in this game.
Chance to make it a 10-point lead. Substitutions as Puo and Bland come in for Effenberger and Littleton. And with 7 minutes and change left, it's a 10-point lead again for the Toros.
This is a coming out party for Jimenez. She redshirted last year from Santa Rosa. She's playing in a championship game, and she has one more year remaining. She has a chance for 20 points. She has clearly been the difference in this game today.
Dominguez Hills, of course, will be a dangerous team for years to come, with a lot of good juniors returning next year. Puo, that's a tough angle, brought down by Champion. It's getting away from the Pios here. Garcia.
This is great coaching by Goodenbauer. Let's call a play. Let's run some clock. Let's get a good shot.
Monet Lee with the shot clock at 10. That might be your dagger. Monet Lee, they're going to call that a long two.
Monet Lee has improved her game every year.
Good defensive play, but the ball remains with the Pioneers.
That's great help side defense. You're seeing the experience of Dominguez Hills. They're playing lockdown defense as well. They have a chance again, Eric, to repeat as the CCA champions.
Lopez. Effenberger from three. That's short. And Champion brings it down. Big second half for Taylor Champion. 6 minutes remaining. 12-point lead for the Toros.
There's their pinch play again. She can double down right there, Eric. You see, she could double down off of that because Rayford is not really going to shoot that basketball.
Lopez and the Pioneers with urgency now, as they need a big comeback and they need it quickly. Pass to Puo. Good matchup for Puo. Draws the foul. She'll go to the line.
That's a great job of the shot lift by Remy Vapu to get her in the air. Now she has a chance for two free throws.
She'll need to convert these. Puo now with 5 points to go with 8 boards. Coach Goodenbauer calling out assignments as Puo knocks down the second free throw. 10-point ball game yet again. Almost a turnover.
That's the trap we was talking about to change the tempo.
Gooden to a wide open Jimenez. And maybe that full court press coming back to haunt the Pioneers there.
That was a great adjustment they made. Goodenbauer called out the press. They was able to break it. Good ball movement.
So Lopez will inbound with 5:20 remaining.
12-point lead could be a tough mountain to climb now, Eric.
Puo able to regain possession and convert. Timeout on the floor called by the Pioneers as they've cut it again to a 10-point deficit. But it looks to be a pretty comfortable lead with 5 minutes remaining for Dominguez Hills as they close in on their back-to-back CCAA titles.
When you have a 10-point lead with 5 minutes remaining, school of thought is each team will get one possession. So if we score out of five possessions three times, we'll win. So at this point, Dominguez Hills need to control the basketball, run the shot clock down, and at least go to the free throw line. East Bay needs to speed the game up now. They need turnovers. If they don't get turnovers and Dominguez scores, it could be a tough mountain to climb for the remaining 5 minutes.
You have to think the Pioneers will go with full court press, and they will. And they'll try to be flying down the floor and getting quick baskets. Tough situation for the Pioneers. Great situation for the Toros here. Garcia up the floor. Foul on Lopez. Garcia to the line.
Excellent job of tracing her down the floor. But they called the foul. That could have been a turnover, but it was a foul. So they'll be shooting double bonus for remaining 5 minutes.
Effenberger checks in for Bland. Pioneers need scores, and they need them fast. I think that's why Effenberger's in. She'll probably shoot a few threes here in the latter stages. 5 minutes left. Full court press by the Toros. Effenberger. Screen by Puo. Pass to Puo. Remy Puo, no foul called, and the Pioneers sideline doesn't like that. Now here's Janae Gooden. Pass to Rayford.
You see the experience of Dominguez here. Now they're going to run offense. They understand now we just need to run offense. Brashears almost picked up her fifth foul.
Brashears has to be careful. Shot clock at 8. This is just what Dominguez Hills wants, taking time off the clock. Foul on Puo.
That's a tough call on Remy DePoo because Breezy ran into her. She was standing. She was holding her ground. Garcia ran into her. That's a tough call.
Did they call that on Brashears?
They called it on Brashears. I thought they called it on Remy.
And Tori Brashears has fouled out. Tough break for Tori Brashears. I thought that foul was on Puo, but Tori will sit for the rest of this game.
They must have got, Remy must have pushed her, Brashears must have pushed her into Remy. I guess that's what they're saying.
So Garcia again to the line. So it looks like maybe with 4 minutes, 22 seconds, it might be a formality here. How about this effort from Dominguez Hills at this tournament, throughout this season and throughout last season, with a chance to have back-to-back titles and this season to win both the regular season and postseason title?
Exactly, and they're going to be good, like you said, next year because they would return a lion's share of their lineup.
Garcia will return next year. Gooden, Monet Lee, Wilson, Jimenez, all will be back next year, so another stellar campaign is to be expected from Dominguez Hills, but they still have 4 minutes to close out here. It would be a historic comeback if the Pioneers were even able to get this close. Kept her foot on the ground, did Walker.
Good
fight for the ball by Bland, but unable to keep possession. Drive by Gooden. Can't get it to go. Rebound by Puo. Pioneers need a three here. Lopez. Pioneer ball.
Coach Gooden was not happy about that. Gooden going in for the layup. Needed to pull that ball out, run some clock. She went in. Gooden wasn't happy about that. It's not about scores now, Eric. It's about possession and running the clock down now.
Our final media timeout here at the women's CCAA basketball championships. I'm Eric Stenholm, joined by Coach Joaquin Wallace. It's been a privilege bringing you these games here on the CCAA website. I'd like to thank our technical crew as well for putting on this production, and thank you for joining us for our soon-to-be 10 broadcasts here from the Stockton Arena.
Eric, I've had an opportunity to call all 9 games. I've seen it from the beginning to the end. 10 hours straight basketball, and it's been outstanding.
It's been a fantastic tournament. Looks like a pretty emotional speech over there from Coach Barkham as the Pioneers know that they're facing a huge, huge uphill climb.
If they can get a quick score here, Eric, I'm sure Coach Barkham designed something, quick score, get into their trapping defense, try to get a quick turnover.
Pioneers would need a minor miracle, but stranger things have happened. This CCAA tournament's had everything. Shot there for Puo is off. Full court press again by the Pioneers.
Next year, Eric, she will not miss those shots.
Puo and Brashears next year look to be a force in this conference as they'll try to return to this tournament. Garcia, screen set by Lee. Garcia, shot clock at 1 from way, way out. Can't get it. Lopez able to grab it. And Lopez sprints up the floor.
They need a quick basket.
Effenberger from way out. That's off. But it'll stay with the Pioneers.
That ball was online, Eric. Just a little too far, but she was straight online with it.
18 points for Jimenez to go with 4 rebounds. 8 points with 11 rebounds for Taylor Champion. 13 and 8 for Rayford, 15 and 7 for Lee. So balanced scoring, balanced rebounding, solid performance from Dominguez Hills in the title game.
Effenberger will be back next year, so they'll have a nice 3-point shooter play. Have Bland as well. They return a good piece of their lineup.
The lead remains 14 with 2 minutes and change left. Shot clock down to 10. Rayford finds Lee. No rush for Dominguez Hills. Jimenez now with 20 points. Huge game for the junior. Big, big collision. Lopez will go to the line. And that's bad news for Dominguez Hills fans as Rayford is down and she pops back up. Big collision between Rayford and Puo.
Coach stepped on the floor. That should be a technical for Dominguez Hills. Coach can't come on the floor unless it's a timeout. I know she was checking on her player. That's what Coach Barkham is saying. There's no way a coach can step on the floor without being a timeout. That should be a technical, but they didn't call it. I understand Goodenbauer is checking on her player.
Timeout called by Dominguez Hills. 30-second timeout. They lead by 16 with 2 minutes and change left. What can you say about Coach Molly Goodenbauer and the season that they've had over in Carson?
Well, Goodenbauer was a solid coach at Chico State. She did the same thing at Chico State. Came back in the league from Irvine. Came back to Dominguez Hills, took over a program that was down. Second year in the program, she wound up winning the conference. Third year in the program, she wound up going back-to-back. So she's an excellent coach, played at Stanford, one of the Stanford all-time great players. Excellent coach.
So congratulations to her. It appears to be just a formality at this point, but you never know. And also congratulations to the Pioneers on a phenomenal season. I was in Pioneer Gym at the start of the year when they took on Fresno Pacific way back in November. And to see them make it to this point, it's a testament to how far this team has come, and we're expecting big things again next year as well. Loose ball recovered by Rayford. Just out of the reach of Bland, and Garcia with a smart move to settle it down.
That's what leadership is, Eric. She didn't take the easy basket. She understands it's all about time and possession. Not about scores right now.
Down to 2 minutes remaining. Foul called.
Excellent job by Dominguez, understanding time and possession. They don't need to score. Breezy Garcia, the junior, understands what needs to happen. Great job by them. That's why Dominguez Hills will be moving on, because their experience showed up here in the second half.
Another thing to look at, Pioneers came into this game on the back of two great performances. Maybe just not enough in the tank for the second half. As it was back and forth in the first half, it was very close. The Pioneers even had the lead in the second half, but a 16-point swing, and it's going to be a victory for Dominguez Hills here. Maybe fatigue could have played a factor, but you have to give all the credit in the world to Dominguez Hills for coming out with a great game plan in that second half.
Exactly. When the conference decided to go to the 16-term format, Eric, it was the idea was to make sure that the top two seeds would have an opportunity to go to the regionals. So they're getting, the league is getting what they wanted with their top seed.
Good battle by Walker to get to the line, the senior in her final game. I'd like to also say congratulations to Stephanie Lopez, Charissa Estramera, Alyssa Palma, and Micah Walker on outstanding collegiate careers.
What a way to end your season, end your career, but they can hold their heads high. Lopez has been here for 2 years, has been part of the change in culture here. But Micah Walker, you pointed out earlier, she was here as in Barkham's second year. I promised her that she'll be playing in a championship game. As you mentioned to me, she delivered on her promise. Micah Walker did play in a championship game in the CC2A championships.
Pioneers have made it four straight years as the number six seed. Finally got the monkey off the back with that win over Pomona, and then became the Cinderella with that victory against Humboldt. Looks like it's about to strike midnight for the Pioneers. 72-57, a 15-point lead. Timeout on the floor. 1:37 left.
Dominguez Hills takes a 30-second timeout. More scoring than this.
Eric, you mentioned you are the play-by-play person for the play-by-play voice for East Bay. How proud are you of what you've seen of your East Bay Pioneers?
Yeah, having been the voice for men's and women's basketball, men's and women's soccer, and baseball, I've seen how difficult it is for a team to transition from Division III to Division II, to try to transition to a new conference. And this team will give us hope at Cal State East Bay and excitement for the future. The Pioneers yet to have won a CCAA title, but this is the start. This is hopefully the start of something great on campus. And I couldn't be more proud of these student athletes for taking the Pioneers to the cusp of a national championship appearance. It's been a great run, and I'm proud to have been on the call the whole way.
At some point, I'm sure Coach Barkham is going to substitute for Stephanie Lopez. The crowd can acknowledge her, as well as Michael Walker.
Yeah, as you see right now, the four seniors all on the floor for the Pioneers right now. Looks like they'll all get the ovation they deserve from the fans as Lopez, Estramera, Palma, and Walker bring an end to their collegiate careers. Garcia unstoppable from the free throw line. Here's Effenberger. Effenberger matched up with Garcia. Walker into the lane. Can't get it to go. Grabs her own rebound. Walker again can't get it.
That epitomizes a night for Michael Walker, Eric. A couple opportunities. Just wasn't able to knock him down.
Foul called. And it'll be Champion going to the line.
Foul number 22, Michael Walker. Third personal. For Dominguez Hills, Taylor Champion.
Champion hits the first. Nice game for Taylor Champion. 12 rebounds. Looking to get to 10 points. So Champion and Jimenez team up with Garcia, Rayford, and Lee. And it's Dominguez Hills who will win the CCAA championship.
It's exciting times for Dominguez Hills as well, Eric. I mean, to win back-to-back, it's hard to win one in this conference. As I mentioned earlier, each year someone else takes the crown home, but for Dominguez Hills to do it two consecutive years, last year being East Bay going three games, and this year being the top seed, was able to stave off all the competition, was able to get this win.
Looking forward, Dominguez Hills will be in that big tournament coming up, the NCAA Division II Championship. Maybe some teams they could be playing. You think maybe a matchup with Alaska Anchorage would be ideal for them, maybe in the, I guess it would be the regional final?
Yeah, because right now Dominguez Hills sits at number three. They'll move up because Humboldt lost. So Dominguez Hills has a chance to move to the two seed, and it looks as though Pomona may sneak in.
Yeah, Pomona, after that loss to East Bay, they were on the bubble. And with East Bay falling here in Stockton, that gives Pomona the opportunity to make it. Do you think there's any case to be made for maybe San Bernardino or UC San Diego, or do you think that's Pomona's spot?
It's going to be Pomona's spot if everything holds true. It looks as though Pomona and Point Loma will be the seventh and eighth seeds.
Alyssa Palma, the senior, tries a three. Way out to Effenberger. Effenberger tries one from way out, brought down. And they'll just play keep away. Under a minute left. Score is 76-57. So it was a close game until the end when Dominguez Hills showed their mettle and pulled away.
Exactly. Showed their championship ability.
Great scene here as the fans cheer on their seniors. At the end of this season, it's been a wild ride for the Pioneers coming to an end here. Shot clock violation.
That's very classy by Dominguez Hills. Molly telling them not to shoot the ball. That's excellent. That's showing class there. There's your seniors
the
coming
seniors
off the floor.
Check out Michael Walker and Stephanie Lopez, and they receive an ovation from the East Bay fans. 29 seconds to go. Palma from three. That's off. Possession with Dominguez Hills, and this should do it. So, Coach, as we wind down here, we both want to congratulate Dominguez Hills on winning the title. We've got the men's title game coming up for you here at 7:30. Final score here will be Toro 76, Pioneers 57. Privileged to bring you this tournament. Some final thoughts, Coach.
Excellent job. Excellent tournament. East Bay has nothing to be ashamed about. Michael Walker, the seniors, did a great job of giving East Bay an opportunity. Coach Barkham, excellent job. They just got to retool for next year, but they have something to go forward on.
For Coach Joaquin Wallace, I'm Eric Stenholm. Thank you for joining us all week long with our coverage of the CCAA Women's Basketball Championship. Stay tuned for the men's game. Eric Stenholm signing off. The final score.